this video demonstration, I will show the gameplay of my finished level and explain the changes I've made. As you can see, I've added a UMG for the start menu. When I press start, it will open up a new level. So I've changed the game to 2D instead of 3D. I was encountering a decent amount of problems while working on the 3D model, so I changed this a week ago. Back in the level, I've added a 3D widget that serves as a tutorial for players. Another problem I was having was the wall running. Wall running doesn't seem to work in 2D, so I just kept the wall jump for players who were having problems getting to higher areas. I've added zombie AI. They roam about. This one seems to be broken. They are one hit kill and you can either kill them or avoid them as a. As you can see, I encountered another glitch. The AI sometimes gets stuck in one place or just avoids the discs. That was another glitch. My collision box touched the zombie, so I died. That doesn't happen a lot. This is like the fifth time I ever had this. And you can see I have a mouse here. I was going to implement it as a directional attack mouse, so you can target different areas. Having some problems with that too, so I removed the feature. I still kept the custom mouse though. There are no checkpoint systems, so I have to restart every time I die. And you can see these meshes. All of the meshes were made by me except for the characters and the animations. They were really hard to find, but there was a video on YouTube that a player, the person actually extracted a few characters from the game Troll Evolution. They were a mixed amount of animations, so I basically tore them apart and made my own animations. And that was the level. So the changes I made, starting from the character blueprint, I redid the whole wall detection blueprint. It's basically a mix of the jetpack of Unreal Tournament, but this is a different version of that. Instead of the jetpack, it actually detects the walls. I actually added a ground slam just in case player gets too high and wants to go down. This was mainly for the 3D version, but I had to remove that. And the directional dodge, the air dodge while you're touching a wall. When the player double taps either A or D, he will dodge in the air depending on the area he's facing. There's a slight bug with the collision, as when you trigger the wall jump or wall run, it suspects each and every wall as a collision where you can actually air dodge. It's not supposed to do that, but I haven't been able to fix it. And I've added physics to the projectile, which I'll show you in the projectile blueprint. And I also added a dissolve material, which I could not use because it's only available on static meshes like boxes or debris. I was trying to implement it on moving characters, but it wasn't working, so I just left it. Moving on to the other blueprints, the zombies I've added, they only have a pawn sensing, so when they detect the player in their sight, they will chase them, and if they're not there, they will roam about to random points. It's slightly difficult in 2D because the zombies also have a turn radius, so they can face somewhere else and they might get stuck. And I've added two pieces of audio, one for the main menu and one for the game. And the box I had for the dissolve, this was an experimental texture, but it works, but it only works on objects that don't move, because when physics is applied, they either fall, they can't stand, they either fall through the ground if they're walls, and if I apply it on two moving characters, they don't animate, they just stand at one place. As for the level design, I made a decent amount of meshes. They were for 3D level, but due to the problems I was having, I changed them to serve as a 2D level. I'll open the map where I've made. So as you can see, these are all meshes. Everything except for the characters and their animations. The rest of the stuff is mine. I used basic lighting. The lighting was the hard part because Tron has a different type of lighting. They all use blues, whites and grays. So the lighting is mostly blue, and it was really hard to add to the backgrounds. Especially the sky. Sky was also hard, but in Tron they use darker skies, more clouds. So I had a fair amount of trouble manipulating the lighting. I used street lights as a prop. These are street lights, but I just use them for the scenery. And I was making a balcony stage for the 3D level, but I had to turn it to 2D, so I just kept it like this. And I was planning on adding multiple elevators. The textures weren't visible, so I had to change this to completely yellow so the player can see them. After I finished my level, I used the level as test run. Many people actually complimented on the level design and the lighting. Many people found the game frustrating because of the wall running problems and the air dodging, but I did get a positive feedback.